think all too often, we are our own worst enemies. We doubt ourselves, we tell ourselves we can't when we can, and we hold ourselves up to an impossible measuring stick. Whether in terms of our transition, we're saying, oh, I'm not as far as that guy, he's got more facial hair than me, or I want this type of body, or in life, like maybe I want a better job, or I should have gotten a degree, or I'm not where I should be in life for my age, or I just feel like a failure, or I should be producing more artistically, whatever it is that we compare ourselves to others with. Social media is both a blessing and a curse. It's a blessing because I can connect with people like you that I would never have found did we not have social media, YouTube and Facebook and Instagram and all these things, and my transition would be even more isolating than it has been. But at the same time, seeing everyone else on social media seemingly leading these happy lives that are uninterrupted by anything negative can be really deceiving. I mean, people post what they want you to see, and most people post their positive selves. Like, I don't feel a need to air my dirty laundry. Does that mean I don't get depressed or upset or don't have issues with people or things? No, it just means I kind of want to keep the stuff I put online happy and positive, and I don't look for the negative in things anyways. I try to look for the positive in things as it is. Either way, it's hard to sit there and look at Instagram or Facebook and see people leading these happy lives that are in far into transition, or maybe are not, you know, whatever it is, or maybe they have a partner, they're in a good relationship, or a job you'd really like to have, and their life is kind of how you want yours to be. You got to put down that measuring stick. I've been thinking about this a lot, because in transition, it all happens at different times. For us, T happens at different times, name changes happen at different times, our changes happen at different times, we're all so different. We all take tea. You could have two people start on the same day, the same dosage, and they could look completely different in 6 months. And I think a lot of our dysphoria is we're looking at people and what they're doing, and we're trying to measure up, and we can't, and it doesn't work. Just put down the measuring stick. Be you in that moment, and that is very hard to do. It is hard to be yourself and just be happy with what you have when you see these good-looking guys with, you know, six-packs and seemingly perfect bodies and lives, and you know, you feel alone looking at from your phone or computer. But trust me, those guys have bad days. I have bad days. Sometimes I have bad weeks, bad months, bad years. But I've learned to just push it down as much as I can, because it's not easy. I'm not saying that I'm totally like free of those things. You know, I was just saying to someone earlier, I was like, you know, I have two cousins that went to my high school to graduate with me. They are both MDs, they are doctors. I'm not. I have my own business, and I work at a thrift store part-time. I do okay, but I don't have, you know, I feel like I should at least have a master's. And I'm like, why? That's society saying, no, you know, you're supposed to do this, go to school, blah, blah. So I shouldn't judge myself. Who cares if I go back to school? Who cares if I have a degree at all? It doesn't matter. You gotta do you. So one thing I've learned in all these years, and really had to come to accept, is to put down the measuring stick. What I really used to measure and what drove me nuts and what drove me to such depression and just angst, trans angst, was measuring myself against cisgender men. And I was talking to someone last night, and we were saying how 10 years ago when I came out, you know, I was the first one to vlog on YouTube, I'm pretty sure. So there were not thousands of vloggers. I could not see me anywhere. I would check out books, like maybe the 7 books that were published at the time. You know, like the Testosterone Files and all these things. Now there's a ton more. And I would just devour them and read them, like the Phallus Palace, all these old school transgender books. So that's how I would find people, and on Yahoo groups and stuff, and that's how I would find my community. But there wasn't so much to compare myself to. I didn't know how to be. I just feel like kind of like I'm a pioneer sometimes, forging into this scary new territory that I'm like, I don't really know what I'm doing, but I'm going to vlog about it. But now, you know, you can go on, you can see surfer guys and guys that like to work out and dudes that are nerdy and like to read, or, you know, there's all, you know, dudes that are into hunting, whatever. There's so many types of masculinities and trans masculinities represented now. It's awesome. But when I was first coming out, it was very much like, it was almost the default to be stealth and not to be out and about, out and proud. And, you know, especially this late in the game, 10 years on TV, people razz me. They're like, oh, you're out. You're still posting your little pictures. And it's like, whatever, I'm living. You know, this is me. I've learned not to stuff it down. I've learned to embrace it and to love it. Yes, being trans is hard, but you can either accept it and move on and enjoy other aspects of your life, or you can just grind yourself to death over it, and I have ground myself nearly to death over it, over lower dysphoria. But I've had to do things like skate and surf and bike and read and write and hang out with people and realize, like, it's not all just about a penis. Even though that's completely terribly painful for me, that's not the only aspect of my life. I've had to put down that measuring tape. And in regards to, basically my whole point was, when I was first transitioning, I wanted to be like a cis dude. I just wanted to, what, I don't know, like, be able to whip it out and pee, and I wanted to, you know, have a normal sized penis, or an adult sized penis, and, you know, experience experience erections, and to be able to ejaculate and that type of thing. And I really kind of held myself up to this cisgender measuring stick. And my happiness and more comfort came in my trans body and the way I navigate the world when I put that down. Now, I'm still working on that in other aspects, like in terms of my job. I feel like I should have more of a career. I feel like, well, more of a profession. I feel that I should have more of a place of my own. Then at the same time, I don't want that. I realized, maybe, or like, I should have a partner at this point in my life. But I realized, like, do I actually want all that? Like, maybe I don't. And it's society that says you should be partnered by the age of almost 32. You should have a permanent place to live. And I'm like, maybe I don't want to own a house. I love being able to pick up the drop of a dime and go where the wind blows me. And that's beautiful. And maybe I don't need that anchor like other people. And my anchor is my soul. So, you know, as long as I'm in touch with myself, I feel at home anywhere. So I'm putting this out there to kind of, I don't know, process some thoughts and just to let people know where I'm at, and that I'm still having a hard time putting down the measuring stick in a lot of social aspects, but not so much in the gender thing anymore. I've learned to embrace it. I've learned to accept it. It's difficult, but when you do and realize this is the path I gotta walk, yeah, it sucks that I gotta pay for chest surgery and for testosterone for the rest of my life. And when I get surgery, it's not gonna be, no matter how many hundreds of thousand dollars I spend, what I would have been born with if I had been born male. But you know what? I am not the person that I am. I would not be the person that I am today had I been born male. And I, you know, used to want to be biologically male so bad, but I don't know. I love being trans in some ways. It's very hard. You know, I'm getting emotional, but, like, healing from surgery and all these things are the hard parts and the social stuff, but, like, the perspective it has given me and the man it has molded me to be, that, you can't trade that for the world. I would not trade that to be cisgender. So, I always ramble, but that's just a few of my thoughts. I hope you're all enjoying your weekend. I'm enjoying my first Saturday off. I don't know how long. I'm just kind of having a chill day and reading and went skating a little bit. But yeah, that's all I wanted to say. Put down that measuring stick. Who cares where everyone else is at? Just do you. And yeah, that's it. All right. Peace, everyone. Take care.